Without further ado, I would like to introduce you one of our favorite people. She is extremely funny. She has a powerful journey that she has undertaken. She's a singer. She's, I believe, a woman of strength, a woman of honor. Please help me to introduce Sihle Seleke.
Right, I'd like all the ladies to stand up, please. Can we all just stand up? I just want you to greet your neighbor. The person next to you, just greet them and say hello. How are you? Just introduce yourself to your neighbor. Please even greet the gentlemen that are amongst us. Hello, everybody. No, but I can't hear you. I'm a loud person, so I'm gonna... There is power in the name of Jesus. Come on, women. There is power in the name of Jesus. Please stand up. Come on. There is power in the name of Jesus. To break every chain, break every chain, break every chain. Come on, I want you to sing with me. I'm not singing alone. There is power in the name of Jesus. All your problems are going. There is power in the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus. To break every chain, break every chain, to break every chain. You know, if you have a problem with another woman, guess what? The problem is you. For the mere reason that you are a woman, and if you allow yourself to have a problem with another woman, the problem is you. Thank you so much, you may be seated. Woo! Women, we are so used to wanting to protect the nonsense that is in our lives. You're looking at me now, you're thinking, oh my gosh, she's tall. Yes, I'm tall, but the heel is helping me. You're looking at me right now and you're thinking, oh my God, you've already judged and prejudged me and decided which category I belong into in your life. And the problem is you, because I have not taken the time to do that to you. So I want to divulge to you that the main problem we have with the feminine hate amongst women is usually ourselves. So you have your own self to blame if people look at you like that, because you cannot give what you do not have. So today it's about time that we acknowledge that most of the problems that we have as women, it starts from within. If you're gonna walk into a room and you're full of low self-esteem within yourself, you give off that vibe to the people that see you. And then you automatically want to translate it as that people by Agnyatsa, they are looking down on you. No, sister friend, the problem is you. You come into a place and you're thinking, oh my gosh, I'm a supermodel, and where I'm going, those people should look at me and bow down to whatever I say. But shame on you, when you walk in here, you meet people like me who do not have time to judge people, and then you think, oh my gosh, abang boni, yes, get a sick bonnet, because the problem is you. You need to sort out your inside. Once your inside is sorted out, that all things will fall into place. Women, we are a topic. Sorry, I wrote a few notes. I had to, because this topic, when Shirley gave it to me, I said, oh my God, where do I start in dissecting and cutting open the problem of a woman? Because I'm a woman myself, and I know that we have major problems. We've got self-hate. We are masters of pretense. We are masters of manipulation. We are masters of causing chaos. And we are masters of pretending that it wasn't us. That man that has left you, you are going around talking to people saying he did this, he did that. Hold on, sister, the problem was you. You are not talking with your mother right now, and you're going around saying it's because she didn't do A, B, C, D. Hang on, sister. The problem is you. You are saying, you know, actually, Mina, I'm a quiet person. I don't have many friends because I'm a loner. Sissy, you have a problem. You're going around saying, actually, Mina, I don't want to get married. I'm that type of woman that wants to be single. Sissy. The problem is you. Abakshele, because when they look at you, your inner self manifests itself, and you find that your inner self is full of hate and wickedness. So when a man wants to come to you to approach you, oh my gosh, he makes a U-turn. People ask me to say, Sihle, how did you do it? I've been married twice. Hallelujah. Clap for me. People ask me, how do you do it? I say, you know what? I had to reach a point in my life where I had to sit down and face myself and say, Sihle uyinkinga. Sihle uyinkinga, and futhi sihle unenkinga, and le nkinga yakho imultiple. So izinkinga, so njenga nginezinkinga, kunengizale phansi ngizilungise mina. I had to stop the pointing game. I had to sit down and say, okay, yes, I am full of hatred. Yes, because my pegu sharing yamzonda because she's thinner than me. When I look at someone else in Gamdwaya, when I look at someone else, I think I'm better than them. So I'm full of hate within myself. I had to be strong enough and bold enough to sit down and say, part of thinking as I'm a manga. Hey, women sin a manga. We have loads of lies as women. You know very well you wear a size 40, but you want to squeeze yourself into a size 36. And then you meet this gentleman who wants to buy you underwear. And he says, baby, just tell me, what size is your underwear? And then you go tell him you are a 36. Because it doesn't fit. And if it does go up, it's a wedgie when it's not supposed to be a wedgie. It's supposed to be full around your buttock. When you put on that bra, I send in Nani the way it was supposed to be because you lie. 42, 36, because you want to impress. And then you wonder why he made a U-turn and never came back. We lie to each other. You see your friend, Duguti, I got gogile in a proper way. But because you want to be superior, you want to feel as though you're the most prettiest, you will not be woman enough to say, friend. It's not the way. But at the same time, no friend. No mungati again, a friend, it's not the way. We are very quick to pick offenses. That is our problem as women. You know, if you sit around men are able to say, no, Mjita, this. They iron it out, it's over. But Tina, you know what our problem is? We walk around with a bag on our shoulders. Do you know the song Bad Lady? Yeah. We've got a bag on our shoulder, and when people look at us, we want to pretend as though we're fine, but we are not. Because in my suitcase, I've got jealousy. In my suitcase, I've got envy. In my suitcase, I've got hatred. In my suitcase, I've got gossip. In my suitcase, Jesus Christ. That's why they say umfazi. When Zulu men try to define the word umfazi. But you know, ufazi. And we think it's a good thing. No, it's not. That is just telling you that the world knows that women have problems. Women are fake. Women have issues. You don't have hair, you're forever wearing a weave, lady friend. The day we're sitting at a salon, you don't want to be seen. Why are you afraid of impandla yakho? Why are you ashamed of your forehead? My goodness, I've got a big backside and I am proud of it.
Tell them.
You know, the enemy is having a heyday with women, especially because we are so distracted by things that we're not supposed to be entertaining. God puts you in a position to say, you are destined for this. But your main problem is, what will people say? Yeah. Or your main problem is, what are they saying? So the way it's complicated in our corner, or the way we are so crazy, we lose sleep over what somebody else thinks of us. Now, if that's a sign of insanity, it is. Because how can you lose sleep because I'm thinking, I wonder if Amanda will love my weave? If you're not sure. I wonder if men kuluma, they're not going to judge my outfit. Why did I open the cupboard and choose it? Conformity is bullshit, women. Gossip is bullshit. Things must come up on the floor and say enough is enough. You know, most women say to me, but Sihle, there are so many women in the country, or so many women in the world, but less men. I say, you know what? If you want to get married, fix yourself. Do not start wearing your knickers and your minis and going to Santon, pretending like you are something that you are not, and you think he's going to take you. You know why? Because men know the difference. They know a difference between, oh, mama wasekaya, no, after 9. So when you are in that category, yoguti, if he needs to go somewhere to be with his fake friends, he picks up the phone and he calls you. But if he needs to go home to his mother, you are non-existent. There is somebody else that he takes home to. So the challenge to women is, what type of woman are you? Are you happy being an after 9? Because, no, you know what? I'm happy. He buys me airtime. I've got a townhouse. He bought me a car. Okay, Sissy, you don't have the title deed. Someone else has it. So what pleases you in that? What pleases you in that? And the sad thing is that we forget that karma is a bitch. In fact, karma is a motherfucker. I'm sorry for using that term. Because you know what happens? You are dating my husband right now. It's good. Date him. You are dating him and doing whatever you're doing with him per appointment. Because I know that when he comes back from fulfilling his appointments, he's coming home to mama. So you wanna please yourself. That's why when women, their boyfriends die who are married, they go more insane than the actual widow. Because they know that he bought you that townhouse, he bought you that car under his name, and the wife didn't know, but see, so when it's time for the estate, I'm taking it all. So you are going back where? Back to your mama's house. Because the problem is that as women, we do not want to fix ourselves. The problem is that we do not want to face ourselves and say, you know what? Sihle, you cannot wear a skinny jean. Sihle, you cannot wear a skinny jean and a top and Sihle, no, you can't. I need to be at a point where even if somebody comes to me and says, Sihle, hi boys, in Mazako Zangaga, I must say, yes, Sisters Antoli Sumendo. But we are so busy, we are complicated with our lives. You know, if you look at 1 Corinthians 6, verse 17, it says, but whatever and whoever is united with the Lord is one with him in spirit. And I believe that true unity comes from being truthful and being true and pure about your inner being. Because oil and water does not mix. Darkness and light does not mix. So if I'm failing to be real about my situation, help cannot come for me. If you're a drug addict, but you are hiding it, there's no way we will say, come, we want to help you. But if you are a prostitute, and I see you prostituting every day, and I say to you, I want to help you, and you don't want me to be helped, There's no way you can be helped by me. So as a result, you and I cannot be united together in spirit. I had a friend who had a problem down there. She phones me and she says, Sihle, I need to see you. I said, but why do you want to see me? She says, no, I need to see you because I have a problem. I said, what's the problem? She said, no, I can't tell you over the phone because I know you're going to laugh at me. I said, no, I do laugh. I do laugh. I'm sure people who know me, I laugh. And sometimes I'm not laughing at you. I'm laughing at what you're saying, or I'm laughing at the situation, or sometimes I'm just laughing at you, but I do laugh. And she says to me, I need to see you. I said, okay, fine, no problem. Let's meet. We met. She says, Sihle. She's not married. Sihle, I've got an issue. Now, I don't work with those terms. Mina, I'm raw. You must say it. What's wrong? No, you know, it's itching now for like 2 days. And I went to the doctor, and now the doctor says it's not what I thought it is. It's cauliflower. And I said, also, unesifo sangaphansi, like something is not right. She says, yes. I said, my friend, where did you get this? Because for me to give advice, ngumamgo sinami, please. So please, what happened? Just share with me. So she says with me to say, actually, I don't know, because I've got Minister of Finance, somebody who pays my bills. I've got a Minister of Transport, somebody who takes me wherever I want to go to. And I've got a Minister of Travel and Tourism, if I want to fly out from Joburg to wherever he's there. Problem. Now, a fake friend would have said, don't worry, friend. Let's go to the clinic and go sort it out. I said, listen, you need to stop your shit. You need to stop your nonsense, because now you are sick. It's the consequences of what you were doing when you thought everything was fine. Number two, all these ministers you are mentioning, they are married. You need to stop this shit. You need to go to the clinic, sort yourself out, and you need to phone these people and cancel the nonsense that you're doing, because I'm not about to promote that nonsense. She says, yeah, no, you're right. I'll call. I said, you're calling them in front of me now. I said, no. If you want me not to tell everybody what you just told me, you are going to call them now. And she called them. She picked up the phone and she phoned them one by one. And I said to her, you're not doing it for them. You're doing it for yourself, because you need to be restored from within. You need to know that the Bible says one woman, one wife. And God will bless you at the right time with somebody who will love you and honor you beyond your issue. But you need to walk in the path. And walking in the righteous path is for you to fix yourself and face yourself to say, yes, I've messed up. And once you've taken ownership of the fact that you've messed up, it's for you to walk straight and not be like a dog that goes back to its vomit. It's for you to walk up with your head up high and say, you know what, I don't care. My friends know me to be living in Sandton, but I'm going back home. Because Sandton was not my place. He was paying for it, and he was eating me illegally. So I'm going back home. And testimony, can I tell you, my friend is married today. It was painful because she had to move from the burbs and back to Soweto. And she started afresh. And people were talking and talking. I said, friend, let them talk. I've heard it all. Let them talk. They spoke and spoke and spoke. Today she's married. And when she got married, I was the only speaker. Because I said, I want to tell them everything. And yes, I did. I told them everything. I said, man, you are brave. You are brave. You've married her. You are brave. But your reward is with God. So what I'm illustrating to you is that God is a God of a second chance. If only we as women can be real with ourselves. If only we as women can come to a point of saying, I can't just enter into a room and hate them. The problem is you. If only we can stop pointing fingers and saying it's him, he, her, whatever. The problem is you, yourself, and you alone. I remember I was invited to speak in prison. Dodi was there. And everyone was talking about how the prisoners would be rehabilitated when they came out. And the biggest mistake they did was making me the last speaker. Because I got up there and I said, yes, I heard, we're gonna rehabilitate you, but you people need to face yourselves. I had to take them back to say, even you as women, think of the day when you were born. Think of when your parents were excited that you were born. Think of the day when you planned this whole thing and in your eyes you saw yourself succeeding and coming uwina with whatever you were planning. Now think of the day when you got caught. And now think of why you are in the situation you are in. Some of you are in that situation where men have paid lobola but he vanished. He never came back to marry you. Some of you are in a situation where a man said I love you and after you opened your legs, he's gone. He's no longer taking your calls. So my message all the time is about within. You can't come and say he's the problem. No. He's the problem, no. He is the consequence of you being the problem. So if you fix you, the outer people will be able to be sorted out. To God be the glory. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Sihle. Thank you so, so much. In order to get in touch with Sihle, she'll be here. She's also on Facebook. Her social media page is Ebenezer. The Lord has kept us this far. That's her social media page. It's Ebenezer, where she shares all her insights and things like that, and also her events and things that she is up to.